Now that we have talked about the different forms of sunscreen, the best one for sensitive skin, and the importance of UVA protection, it's time to talk about the most important things. How much sunscreen do I need for my face and neck? How often do I need to reapply? And what about my vitamin D levels? Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. Whenever I hear a little goes a long way in regards to sunscreen, I die inside. Wherever you stand on sustainability and minimalism, sunscreen application is more a thing of go big or go home, as not applying the correct amount will drastically reduce the amount of protection you get. Even worse, you will think you are protected because you applied sunscreen and be probably less cautious with seeking shade. For a long time, we thought that applying half the recommended amount would give us half the protection, so SPF 25 instead of SPF 50, for example. But recent studies have shown that this is not true. Reducing the amount of sunscreen applied by a quarter already reduced the protection by half, which means that half the recommended amount of SPF 50 will give you actually an SPF of 10. Not much. How much sunscreen do you need to apply for your face and neck? 2 mg of product per square centimeter of skin. Now, that's helpful. I don't know when you did measure your face for the last time, but for me that was never. That doesn't mean that no one does, though. I'm going to link to a video where Lab Muffin Beauty did it. It is hilarious, but most of us will most likely need a rule of thumb. For obvious reason, it's better to apply too much than too little, so a good rule of thumb is around half a teaspoon for your face and neck. Which brings us to the next problem. If you like to cook, you know how hard it can be to eyeball measurements, especially if you use an ingredient for the first time. The solution? Measure it. Pour it into your hand and then get accustomed to how it should look like. To do that, you can either use a measuring spoon or a good kitchen scale. For the average face, it should be around 2 grams of product. And over time, you will get better at eyeballing the right amount. How often should I reapply? Let me start with a quote from a popular skincare blog here. You really do not have to reapply sunscreen every 2 hours. Sunscreens are broken down by the effects of direct exposure to daylight, not by the passage of time. During an average day, a workday let's say, the sunscreen you applied in the morning will still offer enough protection at the end of the day. Well, I disagree. While sunscreen is indeed broken down by direct exposure to daylight or UV rays, which means the protection lasts longer the less UV exposure you get, it also disappears due to sweating and rubbing, which means that every time you touch your face, you lose some of the even layer needed for protection. And I don't know about you, but I touch my face a lot, even though I know I shouldn't because corona and breakouts and other stuff. So even without UV exposure, after 4 hours, you have most likely rubbed away a substantial amount of protection and should reapply. The next thing to consider is the filters you're using. Some, like avobenzone, are unstable if not used in conjunction with other stabilizing ingredients, which means that even without UV light, they lose their protection value. I'm going to link to a video on the different kind of filters here in case you missed it. So if you apply avobenzone in the morning before doing your makeup and then leave the house 2 hours later, you might already have lost all your UVA protection. The rule I personally try to live by is when I'm outdoors, think beach, gardening, hiking, I reapply every 2 hours. When I'm indoors, working in the office, I reapply every 4 hours, which roughly translates to before my lunch break and before I go home again. For full disclosure, in the colder months, I apply in the mornings and maybe before I leave the office because I go by bike. If it's already dark when I go home, I don't bother reapplying at all. But as long as it's summer, this is how I personally reapply. As for the question, how do I reapply sunscreen over a full face of makeup? I will do a separate video on that soon, showing you different ways because so many of you asked in the comments. Now, what about my vitamin D levels? Will I get deficient if I wear that much sunscreen? Well, while the skin needs UVB light to generate vitamin D, that does not necessarily mean that less UV exposure equals less vitamin D. If that was true, people living far from the equator would have lower vitamin D levels by default, as the amount of UVB light that reaches the Earth there is much lower over the course of the year. In addition, black people would be more prone to vitamin D deficiency as their natural melanated skin competes with the UVB rays. Both isn't true. In fact, we have found that nutrition is a much more common reason for vitamin D deficiency than regular use of sunscreen, which explains why the Inuit, getting very little UVB due to where they live and how they are bundled up against the cold, still have good vitamin D levels due to a diet that traditionally contains fatty fish and cod liver oil as source of vitamin D. Other than fatty fish, which I guess might not be everyone's cup of tea, egg yolk and mushrooms do provide some vitamin D too, and some types of milk and orange juice are fortified with vitamin D as well. I get that this diet can be problematic if you try to minimize the intake of animal protein or are full-on vegan, which is where I think a supplement does come in handy. Supplements are usually not my method of choice. I'm a firm believer that a healthy, balanced diet is the way to go, but in this case I would rather take a supplement than risk skin cancer. Of course, you should always check in with your doctor first before you take any supplement. I promise you, however, that no matter how diligent you think you are with applying and reapplying your sunscreen, chances are that there is more than enough skin left uncovered. Think your hairline, your hands, your feet and such, that you get enough UVB exposure for adequate vitamin D levels. Please tell me in the comments how often you reapply sunscreen and if that changes throughout the year. I'm going to link to more videos on the screen now that I think you might enjoy, and I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye!